In the previous video, we showed how to configure OPC Expert for REST API communication. So we saw that it's a REST API server. And in this case, again, we see that we have two OPC UA items and two OPC DA items. I'll actually also connect a couple more here. So OPC TI, this guy here, I'm going to be able to write to this one. And I'll also write an OPC DA item, which is this one right here. There we go. So we'll use this from Python. Now, what's very interesting is we will read first. So take a look. We'll go to flow right here, right click. And in here, I'm going to go to REST API command. Now, if you don't see this REST API command, it is very simply because, and I'll get more room here. If you don't see it, it is because you didn't install the REST API server. So once you install it, you'll see this REST API command. We'll take a look at these in just a little bit, but I will generate a code snippet, and I will do a read, and I'll do this one from Python. So you can see there are a whole bunch of languages here that are available for us to do, and we're going to do this one from Python very specifically. So this copies the code snippet directly to Windows Clipboard. So I do this, and now it's copied to Windows Clipboard. So I'll start Notepad right here. And to get started, I pasted. So I just pasted in here. And now I will save this as, I'll save this to my desktop. And remember, for Python, this needs to be a .py file. So I'll call this read. In fact, I'll call it OPC read.py for Python. And I will save it. Now, this is a very simple file. You can see it's commented. You can see import request, import JSON, time. Shows you also how to fix very common errors, very specifically, if you don't have requests, you've got to run this from command prompt. Another error. Now, this is a small little program here, so while true, in other words, it'll keep doing this. And what this will do is it will get from the REST API server in this location. You can see it's port 57080, and it's going to read a very specific item with this URL right here, not including the quote. So it's actually, this URL, this is the URL itself. Verify equals false, that's how you read. And you parse the response, so you can actually see exactly what we're doing here, and we'll print it out. Wait 1 second, and then this will continue again. So we will read, and every second we'll output the item ID and also the values, just so you can see exactly what's going on. So I will, this is actually already saved. Watch this. I'll just run this, double click it, and we can see the values. Look at the value. Here's the value right here. I'll make this a little bit wider. There we go. It's a little bit easier. And you can see that every second we keep getting new values. You can see the quality in OPC UA, quality of 0 actually means it's good. The timestamp. And you can see this is in UTC. You can do your own calculations. There is the actual item ID, and you can see where it comes from. Okay. Now, I can also edit this with idle right here. We saw a previous video of exactly how to run this. So there it is in idle. And so we don't need Notepad. And you can probably see this even better. Right? So there we go. So this is what it looks like. Now, what I want to do at this point, so I will, again, I can run module, and this will run a little bit different. So I can see this in the idle environment. And there we go. Idle environment is a little bit nicer. So now you're seeing that we're getting these values and we can do whatever we want with them. Now, let's close this. And now what I want to do, go back here, and I will go to a DA item. So I'll take random very specifically. Now, once again, I could actually go to REST API command. I can generate the code snippet. I can read, and I could do Python again. So it will generate something very, very similar to this. Of course, the only difference is it will be with a different item ID. So instead, I'll just do this time. We'll copy the item ID right here. So copy item ID, I click it, there we go. Now it's in my clipboard. I'm going to take this. So the item ID, as I showed you earlier, is right here. And we'll keep on going with the arrow. Okay, up to the quotation. There's the item ID. So this is the old item ID. I will now paste. So there is the new item ID. So this is the new item ID right here. And now, the reason I did this, when I run, watch, I'll run this, run module, of course. It expects me to save, so that's fine, so I'll save it. And now, I'm looking at another item. And if you want to compare, there's the value in OPC Expert. And you can also see the value coming down. The timing might be a little bit off, but by and large, these are the same. Okay, so now we read from OPC UA, and we also read from OPC DA. I'm going to close this, and now we'll do a write example. All right, so what I'll do here is I'll right-click, copy, right-click, paste. Right-click, paste, but here, we'll paste. I'm just copying the file, and I'll make this file called OPC write. Of course, it's the same read code. I'll edit it with idle. Again, there we go. It's the read code. Okay, I just tried to save some time. Maybe it wasn't worthwhile. In any case, I'll delete this. I suppose I could have just made a new file. Okay, in any case, here we've got memory, and you notice the type is a double. So we got a data type of double. So once again, right-click. It doesn't matter where right-click, but right-click REST API command, generate code snippet, and I want to write this time. Once again, we'll do it in Python because this is a Python video. I will right-click, paste. So there we go. So you can see that it's really very, very similar to what we had before, but this time the write is a little bit, for the write, it's a little bit different. And you can see the value right here. So there is the value, which is actually a variable, which is over here. So for example, instead of value, I can say 2 or 5, but we decided to show something a little bit different. So what we're going to do is while true. So in other words, keep this going forever. We're going to write a value. So the value here is 0. and then we're going to print it out again, just like before. And then we'll go value equals 1 minus value, so 1 minus 0 is 1. We'll sleep 2 seconds. This will then become 1. Here we'll go 1 minus 1 is 0, so it'll go 1, 0, 1, 0 every 2 seconds. So easy code to follow here. Again, you see the comments. I will run this. Ask me to save. Okay. And there we go. And here, you can see what's happening here. And if I go back to OPC Expert and check this out, so we see the same value here as we see up here. It's writing. And it's constantly writing, and you can see every time it writes, this value here changes as well. So you really know that there are no tricks here. It really is writing. Okay, so now I'll go and write over here to this one, and I'll do the same trick as before. So let's get rid of this guy. REST API command will copy the item ID. There we go. So this is the item ID itself, because that's really all I need to change. And there is the item ID right here. So this is the ID, and paste. And here you can see the new item ID is right here. Run. Run module. Yes, I'll save. And now, sure enough, you can see. There we go. You can see this guy is now changing from 0 to 1. So, pretty cool stuff. You can play around with this. You can see what exactly is going on. For example, you can take a look at the other parameters, but this shows you pretty clear, I think, how to read and write data. So we can get the URL, so the entire URL, for example, for reading and writing. There's a QR code, so you can bring it to, just so you see this, it's a point, we'll do a QR code. You can point your phone at this when you do this on your own computer. Don't do it in the video because it won't work. But here, REST API command, you got to check out that. So we'll write and copy to clipboard. This is, was this a URL? I forget what this was. Hang on. Be easier if I do this. REST API command, URL endpoint, write, copy to clipboard. And here, what you see is the full command for custom value. So so everything is right here. All right. So you can play around with that. All right, guys. Please go ahead. Enjoy. Give us some feedback. Let us know what you think about this. Here we go. I'll just run this again. F5, I'll save it, and sure enough, I am actually writing here. So, guys, let us know what you're thinking for Python, reading, writing. Hopefully, that should work out very nice for you. Good luck.